Hello everyone, welcome back to the course of fluid mechanics for GATE and IES. This is lecture number 10, Newton's law of viscosity, part 3. These are some useful instructions for watching the video in YouTube. Please go through it. This is our course syllabus. Now we are dealing with the properties of fluids. These are the previous lectures from this course. We already covered the basic concepts and the basic properties and the viscosity concept in detail. The links for the video are given in video description. This is lecture number 10, and now we are talking about the applications of Newton's law of viscosity. If you are a new learner, please watch the previous lectures for better understanding before proceeding. The links for the video are given in video description below. If you are a new learner, please subscribe our channel for effective learning. We will upload lectures to cover the whole syllabus soon. If you like the video, please press the like button. Now let us move on to our discussion topic. In previous lectures, we discussed about the Newton's law of viscosity and analyzed one application with the conceptual analysis, which is the shaft rotating in the fluid. Today we are going to cover two more cases. The first one is inclined surface and block. Second one, horizontal surface and block. So before proceeding further, I will quickly revise the important concept that we have covered already. We know due to viscosity, the fluid offers resistance against motion. So viscosity, the property by the virtue of which fluid offers resistance to motion. So due to this resistance, there is a resistance force and there is a resistant shear stress, that is called viscous shear stress. The viscous shear stress is given by Newton's law of viscosity as tau equal to mu into du by dy. But tau is the shear stress, mu is the coefficient of viscosity or absolute viscosity, or dynamic viscosity, du by dy is called velocity gradient. Where du is the linear velocity of the fluid film and dy is the fluid film thickness. So by using this equation we can compute the shear stress and the shear force, and further we can find out the torque and power loss as we did in the previous lecture. So today we are going to analyze the first case. So let us take the first case, that's inclined surface and block. The case of inclined surface and block that we already learned in the engineering mechanics, where in an inclined surface there will be a block sliding. But here in fluid mechanics, that is the case of viscosity, we will do some modifications like this. So I have a case, an inclined surface. Let the angle of inclination be theta. I'm marking this is a flat surface. So some block is sliding here. In engineering mechanics, the block will be sliding directly over the surface. But for smooth sliding, I am applying some lubricant here. That lubricant will provide some lubrication and the block will slide very smoothly. So I am giving some lubricant film here. So some lubricant film is applied here. So that lubricant, let the thickness of the lubricant film be Y. That's the thickness of lubricant film. It will be in mm, very small thickness, and the viscosity of the lubricant, that viscosity mu is the viscosity. So this is a block. So what happens? When this angle increases, the block will start sliding due to this gravity force which is pulling in this direction. So the gravity pull in this direction, so the block will start sliding. But when the block will start sliding, the fluid film which is in contact with the block will offers resistance against its motion. So there will be a resistant force backward, which is the viscous force. So due to this viscous force which is opposing the gravity pull, here is the gravity pull, so the block will be like this. So the block is sliding here due to gravity, and on the opposite direction due to the viscous force will be there. The fluid film below this block, this is the block, the fluid film below this block will offer viscosity, so the viscous force will be opposing. So due to this gravity and viscous force, the block will slide with an constant velocity. That will be the initial velocity at the beginning of the sliding, which is called terminal velocity. So in questions they will ask you to find out the terminal velocity of the block or the velocity of sliding of the block. But if we further increase the slope, that's when we are increasing the slope, then the block will, the gravity pull will be very high compared to the viscous force, so the block will start moving downwards with acceleration. But today we will only deal with the case with this constant velocity or terminal velocity case. So now we are going to analyze this case with mathematical formulations. So this is a inclined surface which makes an angle theta with the horizontal, so this is a vertical surface. So here the fluid film, the block is placed here. So the block will have a weight W equal to mg, where m is the mass of the block, and g is acceleration due to gravity, which is 9.81 meter per second square. We already explained it. So the viscous force will be acting in this direction. This is the viscous force F, and the gravity pull will be acting in this direction because it is sliding this direction. So for finding this one, we will resolve this weight. So if we draw a normal here, this angle will be theta, and due to this weight can be resolved. This is mg cos theta or w cos theta, and this is mg sin theta. So if you resolve, so the block, I'm drawing it separately. So this is the weight w equal to mg, and this is a normal. I can resolve it like this. If the angle is theta here, then it is w cos theta or mg cos theta, w equal to mg, weight w equal to mg, which is the weight of the block, and this is w sin theta or mg sin theta. So the gravity force on this block is mg sin theta. For sliding, total gravity force is w equal to mg, which is the weight, and it is resolved into two. One is sliding here, it is mg sin theta, and the opposing force is this viscous force. So when the mg sin theta force is just above the viscous force, the block will start sliding. So the viscous force F equal to mg sin theta at the beginning of the sliding. So now we can apply the Newton's law of viscosity, tau equal to mu into du by dy, where tau is the shear stress. Shear stress we can write it as shear force divided by area equal to mu into du by dy, where du is the sliding velocity, which we can represent it as v, and dy is the thickness, which we thickness of the fluid film, which we can represent as y. So y is the thickness of the fluid film and v is the velocity of the block and mu is the coefficient of viscosity, f is the force which we got here mg sin theta, and a is the area of contact with the fluid film from the block. It is the bottom area of the block. If the length and width of the block is given, we can compute the area. So from here, force is equal to mg sin theta divided by area equal to mu into velocity divided by fluid thickness, from which we can compute the velocity as mg sin theta into y divided by mu a, or mg can be written as weight w sin theta into y divided by mu a. This is the terminal velocity of the block. Okay, the A is the area of contact with the fluid film. It is the bottom area of the block sliding. I hope you understand how we derive the equation. It's a simple equation. You can remember it. It's a W sin theta into Y divided by mu A. Okay, now we solve one simple question based upon this concept. So a 1 kilogram rectangular box having length 10 cm and width 5 cm sliding over an inclined surface having inclination 30 degree to the horizontal surface. For smooth sliding, 0.1 mm thick lubricant film having viscosity 0.03 Pascal second is used between the sliding surface and block. Find the terminal velocity of the block in meter per second. So they asked the velocity. So well, for velocity we have the equation. It is mg sin theta into y divided by mu a. So the case is like this. There is an inclined surface. The angle theta equal to 30 degree it is given. The block is here. And the thickness of the fluid film. Thickness of the fluid film y is given as 0.1 mm that you have to convert into meter. That's equal to 0.1 into 10 raised to minus 3 meter. And the weight of the block, mass is m equal to 1 kg and g equal to 9.81 meter per second square, and then mu is given as 0.03 Pascal second, and area we have to compute. The length is given as 10 cm, that is 10 into 10 raised to minus 2, which is the length in meter, multiplied width, that is 5 into 10 raised to minus 2. So if we compute the area here, we will get the area as 0.005 meter square. So we can substitute in this equation, m is 1, g is 9.81, sine 30 into y is the thickness 0.1 into 0.1 into 10 raised to minus 3 divided by mu is 0.03 multiplied by area is 0.005. So if you multiply, we will get it is at 3.27 meter per second. So the terminal velocity of the block is 3.27 meters per second. So it's a simple question which is a direct substitution. Now we are going to analyze one question which was asked in ESE 2010 from the similar concept. A thin plane lamina of area A and weight W slides down a fixed plane inclined to the vertical at an angle of alpha and maintains a uniform gap theta from the surface of the plane. The gap being filled with oil at constant viscosity mu, the terminal velocity of the plane. So they ask the terminal velocity V. But we for that we know the equation, it is mg sin theta into y divided by mu A. But this is the case with the inclination is with horizontal. This is a horizontal. But in this question, there is a twist. The plane inclined to the vertical. It is not to the horizontal. So the case is like this. A similar lamina. The angle given alpha is here. So the block will be like lying like this. And there will be fluid film here. And it is sliding. So we have to find out the velocity. The angle alpha here. For that you have to compute. We know that this is a right angle. So if it is alpha, then it is 90 minus alpha. So if it is 90 minus alpha, we can substitute here. So we can compute mg into sine 90 minus alpha into y. Y is the thickness of the fluid filling. The thickness is given as zeta divided by mu, then area is A. So weight is given mg equal to w. So it is w sine 90 minus alpha into zeta divided by mu A. So sine 90 minus alpha equal to cos alpha. We know this. So we can substitute here. It will be w cos alpha into zeta divided by mu A. We can rearrange it. It is zeta into w cos alpha divided by mu A. So we can check for the correct answer. This is not correct because w is here, and this is not correct. So the correct answer is zeta w cos alpha divided by mu A. So when reading the question, you have to be careful. Don't mark wrong answers. Be careful when reading the question and mark the correct answer. I hope you understand how we solve this problem. Now we can go to the second concept, which is the horizontal surface and block. So the second case is horizontal block and horizontal surface and block. A similar types of problems we will learn in engineering mechanics also. So in this case, there's a horizontal surface and here is a pulley and we have a block here. There is a lubricant filling for smooth sliding and this block is connected through a string or rope to another block and it is moving here. So the weight of this block is, I'm taking mass is m1 and m2 here. So the question is, what will be the terminal velocity or the sliding velocity of block? So we can analyze here. This block, which is having mass m2, which will be weight, will be acting downwards, gravity will be pulling here. So due to this pulling effect, there will be a tension here in the rope. Since it is a single rope, the tension will be same here also. So this, due to this m2g or weight of this block, due to this gravity pull, that the same tension will be pulling this block m1g. The weight will be acting like here. So the tension is pulling the block rightwards. But what is there? When the block is moving in the right direction, in this direction, there is a fluid filling below that. That fluid filling will offer resistance due to viscosity. So some viscous force will be acting here. So initially, when the weight of this m2g is very, when the weight mass is m2g is very small or the gravity pull is very small, this will not move. So if you are increasing this weight m2, then when the tension will increase, and due to the increase in tension, this tension will overcome this viscous force. At that point, the block will start moving. So at that point, there will be a velocity. When the mass is increased again, then it will be converted into an accelerated motion. But we will not deal with that accelerated motion. We will deal with that terminal velocity or the sliding velocity at the initial, which is a constant sliding velocity for just moving. So we will find out that. For that, we have to analyze this situation. Here we can easily identify, since it is in the equilibrium, the tension is equal to m2g. Here the tension equal to m2g. The same tension is acting here. So that viscous force F equal to tension, which is equal to m2g. Okay, so since we got the viscous force, we can substitute in Newton's law of viscosity, tau equal to mu into du by dy for finding the velocity du. So it is F by A equal to mu into du is the velocity of sliding and y is the dy is the thickness of the fluid film. So we can find the velocity v equal to f into y divided by mu a. So here f is equal to f is m2g into y by mu a, where m2 is the mass of the second block, not this block. So because why? Because the pulling is due to this m2. So the equation for terminal velocity in this case v equal to m2g into y divided by mu a, where m2 is the mass of this second block and y is the thickness of the fluid film, thickness of fluid film, and mu is the coefficient of viscosity or absolute viscosity or dynamic viscosity. A is the area of contact with this block. So this is the area of contact with the sliding block with the fluid film. So if we know all these things, we can compute the velocity easily. I hope you understand the concept here with the case of an inclined surface and a horizontal surface. So I am winding up this lecture here. In next class, we will be dealing with the velocity distribution and applications of Newton's law of viscosity. So before winding up, I have a question for you. It is a simple question which we solved earlier. So here you want to find out the inclination of the surface with the horizontal. I hope you can solve the question very easily because we know the equation and you have to just substitute and find out the angle theta. So if you solve the question, please comment your answer in the comment section. We will review it and we will give you the suggestion. If you have any queries or questions, please ask in the comment section. Thank you for watching. Please rate us. Your opinion matters to us. We want to improve continuously. And please subscribe our channel if you love the video and share this video to your friends also. You can give suggestions and you can ask questions in the comment section. We will try to reply as fast as possible. Thank you for watching. Thank you.